fiends roam this place.
Rare Griffin variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. Griffins are a union of bird and beast that soar through the skies on mighty wings and take down prey with sharp claws. These creatures have existed for eons and appeared in countless legends, yet have never undergone scientific study. Or perhaps those who tried fell prey to the beast's hallucinogens. Sightings of this variant are even rarer still, making this a golden opportunity. Remember, though, to keep an eye on those tail feathers as you proceed with your investigation.
legends. Bahamut once took shelter somewhere in these lands after being severely wounded in a fierce battle. Its scarlet hue is said to represent the divine protection the Earth bestowed upon it during the entity's long convalescence.
Lifespring, I was able to locate a new transmuter chip. It's buried in some nearby mountain ruins. Currently, a survey of these ruins is in progress, but we suspect they were built by the ancients, or others like them. Perhaps you could conduct an investigation of your own while looking for the transmuter chip.
Thank you. It's lucky I sharpened my claws.
Rare golem variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. Strictly speaking, golems are not living creatures. They're soulless clay dolls, animated only by the life stream. It is thought that the ancients created them long ago with their unique technology, though it remains unclear why they would have left their constructs in a place like this. We may never know the answer. After the disappearance of their masters, the golems fell into disrepair. Corrupted by impurities flowing through the life stream, they grew violent. Please put an end to their destructive rampage, for the sake of the locals, if nothing else.
Sephiroth has come back from the dead, right? And that's a bad thing. So, what I want to know is, how'd they do it? And what's he after?
He wants to save the planet.
But wouldn't that make him a good guy?
It's not what he's doing, but how. He doesn't give a shit if everyone dies in the process.
Sounds like a total nutter. I mean, there's not much point in having a planet if there's no one left to enjoy it, is there?
That said, let's not forget that we still got a whole nother problem. One that's reared its ugly head time and time again. Bunch of assholes who won't stop till they let the planet dry. Send them. To hit them where it hurts, we'll need to leverage those connections of yours. But if you even think about stabbing us in the back, I'm gonna hug and squeeze you to death, you hear me?
What are we on?
Sacred sanctuary where the planet's greatest minds gather.
It's beautiful. More than I ever imagined. Come on, let's pick up the pace. I can hear it calling my name.
Yeah, me too.
Let them through. They're good people. I promise.
After all, they're the reason I'm here.
What in the hell was that? Hey guys, it's me! Who?
He's such a softie.
Real quick, gotta check something. An airship dropped these on us this morning. Wanted posters of the terrorists who bombed those reactors. But I think we can say you had nothing to do with all that. Even if Nanaki hadn't vouched for you, it's obvious. Welcome to the Sanctum of Planetology, Cosmo Canyon.
Of us, and we of it. As such, the life with which she has blessed us is a gift that must one day be returned. To nurture your spirit is to nurture the spirit of the planet. And so, I implore you, brothers and sisters, do not neglect your studies, nor your prayers. Through your diligence, you will find true fulfillment.
Have a look around. Come on. You are the
Cosmo Canyon, Cloud. A long-standing dream of mine has finally come true. Planetology rejects our Mako-consuming society, insisting that we have much to learn about this world. And now, we have the opportunity to share in their planetary knowledge. If there's anything else I can do for you, please let me know. I'm always happy to help.
customer?
Oh, and, please come again.
Welcome to shop here.
You dare use my weapons for anything unsavory.
Thank you.
I was born and raised here, in this canyon. I was to become a watcher of the Veil like those before me, until I was taken by Shinra. Now that I'm home, and have repaid my debt to you, I plan to serve my village once more. I appreciate all that you've done for me. Thank you.
We're really gonna miss you, Red.
Oh, don't say that. You're only making this harder. I mean, I wish we had more time, but this is my duty.
I suppose it was your duty to act the old man.
I wanted you to treat me as an equal, not a dog.
Not a pig! Is that you, my boy?
Coming!
So, was that goodbye?
Nah, I'm sure we'll see him around the canyon. The real question is, why'd we come here? To learn the secrets of planetology! Come on!
Can't forget that materia!
As for me... Ah, that'll do. I'm gonna steal some shut-eye, if you don't mind.
Then, we can see the sights!
May serve as a traveler. You've more than a passing interest in Queen's blood. It has bewitched you. Be at ease. It is only natural to hear its call. Queen's blood is of the planet and for the planet. It, like all things, is part of the great cycle that connects us. Indeed, each and every card holds within it a greater purpose, one that belies their form. Come, join me in a match. That you too may glimpse the truth of our great mother. turn I did not expect, which confirms my fears. A strange, wicked pall hangs over the life stream, and a similar dark energy has corrupted Queen's blood. Be careful. The game's pleasures belie the thorns beneath that will bleed you slowly and surely. Many devotees have succumbed to the darkness of which I spoke. Too many. Remember, the cards are a link between us and the planet. If you are in trouble, reach out. She shall answer. Oh, Great Mother, hear my prayer. Watch over your son.
Of the day, folks! We have ourselves a challenger! Hello, sir! Care to tell the folks at home who you are? Ha ha ha! Could this shark be more of a guppy? Well, I spy a row of razor-sharp teeth in this little fishy's maw! You might be the QB killer we've been waiting for, but there's only one way to find out! That's right! Our audience doesn't want to hear commentary, they want to see blood! To up the ante, our challenger's opponent will be none other than your host with the most, me, Bernard! Talk about carnage, am I right? I'm lucky I got out of that match with my limbs intact. Today's shark is a ferocious man-eating menace. He made a serious splash with some ruthless moves. Players the world over have got to be shaken in their boots. Something tells me this beast is about to upset the QB food chain. Better start swimming. Congratulations to you, sir, for an incredible match. Though we found the canyon's resident shark, the fun never ends on this show. Stay tuned because we've got more coming your way.
Professor Gast often visited the Fiend.
Fancy running into you here. Say, how about I get a shot of you giving thanks to the planet? The canyon's also famous for its unparalleled view of the starry night sky. I made sure to bring all my night photography equipment along. Can't sleep until I've got the perfect starlit shot. Just let me know if you find any good photo spots. So expansive and enthralling.
A seminar is in progress.
Blessings of the planet upon you. Disciples of her teachings gather here to share their experiences. Through these seminars, we learn from one another and together enrich our lives. Participation in the seminars requires a special invitation from a mentor. Without one, I'm afraid you cannot join. Perhaps you might instead consider taking part in the River of Light ceremony. I suspect you'd enjoy it.
Up close like we did, they'd have no choice but to acknowledge how bad it really is. Folks around here, though, they get it. They want what's best for our planet. You can see it in their eyes. Wonder if it ain't too late to recruit them to Avalanche.
To the blessings of the blood.
This liquor has an unmistakable.
Lift your gaze to the heavens. Watch as the clouds.
We need only open our hearts.
To the planet, we will now embark on.
Just as all things begin, the planet. So do.
Bless the planet.
Stock up on whatever you need.
breeze. It's really nice. I'm gonna become a whole...
The place has been open every day.
Tonics, liniments, filters. We have everything you need to cure what ails you.
Is that SSL? Used to be a soldier. Lots of hand signals. That's how Shinra Sign Language came to be a thing. I know the basics. Queen's blood, huh?
Thank you.
good fight, though. Hang on. Are you ex-military, too? Solid idea. Good luck with that.
The starlit night is yours. Planet's blessings.
I told you the person I got to sub for me was managed.
It said that these caves were formed from our...
There's no finer sound in all the world than the voice of a humble piano. Of course, the path to musical enlightenment is without end. Which is why I ask your continued assistance in sharing the joy of music with the world.
Grace of the planet. May we enjoy our lives and this meal before us. From our brethren, are we given life? And unto them,
these devils.
Welcome to the
silver. Ours is the most storied.
This is the...
Finally,
Fiend. Oh, great mother.
Hearken to the wisdom of the planet. It is boundless and infinite. And we may share it.
I'm afraid I can't let you pass.
Thank you. These are the friends I was talking about.
Thank you for looking after Marmagin. My name is Vulcanhagen. I teach planetology here in the canyon. One could say I know a thing or two about our world.
A thing or two? I doubt there's a thing or two you don't know about it.
Well, it might seem that way to a child like yourself.
I'm not a child anymore. I'm 48.
40 what?
Nanaki here has a long life ahead of him. In human terms, I would say he's about 15 or 16 years old.
That's more than old enough. I can protect our Vale and everyone in it. Which is more than I can say for my good-for-nothing father.
Speaking of the members of our little community, have you announced your return to one and all, Mamaki?
Not yet. Be right back.
But where are my manners? Please, come in and have a look around. A scale model of our planet and the surrounding stars. One could say the dust it's collected represents the people who live upon it. In his childhood, Nanaki was quite a handful. That is one of the first Mako detectors ever built. I suspect it can't detect much now. Nanaki never had much exposure to the outside world. I can only hope his travels with you have served to enlighten him. Larger telescope on the planet. With it, you can see to the edge of the galaxy. There's no better view of the stars than through this scope. But the lens could do with some cleaning. My apologies. Thank you.
The lights we observe here have traveled to us from the far reaches of time and space. To gaze at the stars is to gaze into their past, what they once were, eons ago.
Can't say I'm all that interested in the future.
Too often of late. This tubing allows us on the surface to hear the inner voice of the planet.
What we just heard didn't come from the planet, though. That was definitely the voice of a weapon.
You seem awfully sure of yourself, miss.
Because we saw them, with our own eyes. Two, in the Corel and Gungaga reactors. They were loud and huge.
Fascinating account, were it true. However, such grand delusions could be a sign of Mako poisoning. Do see a doctor.
Excuse me?
Oh. Yes. That would do them some good. Judging from everything you've said, the three of you are unfamiliar with basic planetology. But it is never too late to learn. Please, come with me. Present to you our planetarium. While the Shinra building features the latest iteration, this particular one is my original design. Now then, without further ado. Only the beginning.
A shooting star.
Planetology is not simply the study of the cosmos and the celestial bodies that dwell in it. Rather, it is a quest to comprehend the cyclical nature of life. Behold, the planet we call home. It was from its soil, so teeming with life, that mankind was born. And like all living things, man is fated to die. So, what happens next? The body withers and returns to the planet. But what of the mind, the spirit, the soul? Much like its former vessel, it too returns whence it came. To the great river where all intertwine and circle the planet without end. A cycle of continuous convergence and divergence. The ceaseless ebb and flow that is the life stream. An apt name. Though it is as much a reservoir as it is a stream, the being the sum of the planet's spiritual energy. It is the very essence of our star. The blood coursing through its planetary veins. And if ever that essence were to be entirely depleted, basic principles of planetology.
So you're saying that Mako is spiritual energy, which we're using up?
Just so. Siphoned from the planet and processed for industry, that energy can no longer fulfill its true purpose. It is fated to fuel man's machinery, then fade away.
Okay. But does it actually fade away? I mean, what if it doesn't? What if it just returns to the Lifestream in a different form? Is that possible?
A novel theory, suggestive of a lack of understanding. However, that can be overcome with time and education.
You rang?
Please escort this young lady to our seminar room, would you?
Right this way. Okay.
Hey, can I come?
Got a question. Planet runs out of energy. It and everything on it dies, right?
Yes.
There any way to avoid this? Like, making the spiritual energy stronger?
Why are you asking me such things? I'm sorry. I've come to realize that I'm somewhat stuck in the past. We've entered an era in which humanity exerts unprecedented influence over its environs. And as both the planet and society evolve, so too must science. And yet it seems that I cannot. Perhaps I'm much too old of a dog to learn any new tricks.
Thank you.
we observe here have traveled to us from the far reaches of time and space. To gaze at the stars is to gaze into their past, what they once were. We observe here have traveled to us from the far reaches of time. We've all been worried sick about Nanaki, fellow Bugenhagen chiefly among us.
Thanks so much for taking such great care of Nanaki for us. Fellow Bugenhagen instructed me to let you take anything you think might prove useful on your journey. Check out the storeroom when you have a chance. Thank you.
nothing to fear. It is not our fellow man, nor any creature big or small, with whom we share our home. It is that which comes from beyond the confines of this world. That which disrupts the natural order. The other which may attempt to claim and consume the planet. And so I bid you, her children, to join hands and come together. For united, we shall never succumb to fear of celestial calamity.
So expansive and enthralling. Our planet is the greatest artist. The way the shadows carve out the red stone, it's perfectly balanced. There's something that's truly magical about the harmony of natural structures.
Within you all are the planet's thoughts.
I heard from fellow Bugenhagen. By all means, please come and join the seminar. Follow me if you would.
Which would you say is a more worthy pursuit?
They are both one and the same. Wouldn't you agree?
I ask you this. Who among you has looked inward?
So many seminars.
A seminar is in progress.
I've always been on the bigger side, but I've never been into physical...
Please, continue on into the assembly.
More my thing. My old man, he used to say it was a waste, me spending all my time indoors. According to him, a big kid like me was using twice as much spiritual energy as other folks, and I was a burden on the planet.
What about you, miss? You must have a story to share. Please.
Me? Okay. Where to begin? I fell into the life stream. I don't have words to describe it, except beautiful, maybe? It was a lot to take in. Feelings of kindness washed over me. Long-forgotten memories came flooding back. It was a warm, comforting place. But there was also conflict. A war between the planet and its enemies. And we can't let them win. We need the planet, and it needs us. We have to rise up, fight back, defend it from this terrible threat. Thing is, I don't know how to do any of that. And I hoped you might have the answer. I'm not criticizing planetology or anything, and I'm not trying to scare anybody either. I just... you know... never mind. This is all coming out wrong.
Please, do not be discouraged. Should you ever wish to try again, we would be more than happy to listen. What matters is that you keep challenging your beliefs. Stop doing that, and the answers will forever elude you. On that note, I think we should adjourn for the evening. The River of Lights is almost upon us, so let us head to the torch.
See you at the festival.